Welcome back to Qatar and the LaSalle International Circuit. There's a long history of two-wheeled motorsport action here, but in 2021, Lewis Hamilton won out as part of an epic battle that year with Max Verstappen. But who will win out tonight? We're back here in LaSalle for a track that's 3.34 miles long. There are 16 turns around its unique three-pronged shape and just a single DRS zone out of turn 16. It's fast and it's flowing, and there's a good overtaking opportunity with DRS down the long straight and into turn one. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, just ahead of George Russell, who starts this event from P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Sainz, Perez, Norris, Maverick, Fernando Alonso, Gasly, Ocon, Magnussen, Oscar Piastri, Joe, Bottas, Leclerc, Albon, Hülkenberg, Tsunoda, Drugovich, Sargeant, Stroll, and Nyck de Vries. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. Anthony Davidson also joins me in the commentary box today. Let's talk about Maverick. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do. And that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
Launch map is good, but we need to learn the gears, so go into each one when you can. We're going to need some work on the brakes, so put some energy into them and warm the tyres as well, please. Superb parking there, mate. Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. Let's focus now for the rest of the race. Okay, so the gap to the car ahead, 5.9 seconds. By 8.0 seconds. Okay, keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 8.2 seconds. Available on the MFD. Okay, here's the gap that we're trailing the car ahead by. 11.9 seconds. Perfect job from you and the crew there, mate. We're delighted with that. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tyres. We'll be right back. Caution, caution. Okay, be aware, there's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags. Green flag. Behind is 11.3 seconds. We need to get past. Us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. right, no issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Take them now. Teammate by 21.8 seconds. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 11.9 seconds. Okay, just two laps of fuel remaining now. And that's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
And Mercedes have pulled off a great victory here today. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it.